Hello and welcome back to Module 3 of this e-learning course on digital skills. Module 3 is all about how to create digital resources and content, and we're going to have a quick look at web design during Part 5 of Module 3. During this Part 5, we're not going to talk about actually how you make a website. We'll point you in the right direction of some of these resources later on, but we are going to show you some tools that you might decide to use. The most important thing before deciding on building a website is actually thinking about what the purpose of it might be in the first place. So many individual classrooms, so many individual schools create a website which is then impossible to update, and it just becomes a really, really dull resource that puts your school in a bad light. So you need to be thinking about the layout, what pages, what content, and again, what purpose the website is going to have before you set out on your journey. Now, there's lots and lots of tools that you could potentially use. WordPress.com or WordPress.org is an open source blogging platform, but actually now WordPress is used to create an awful lot of the internet. It's really, really sophisticated, and WordPress is a great place to go if you're going to create a whole school website. There are other websites that you might decide to use as well. One of these might be Weebly.com. Again, a lot of these services are either free but supported by advertising, or freemium, which means that you will be able to use it for a certain time period or up until you've used a certain amount of storage, and after that time there might be some cost. But Weebly, a really simple way to kind of create a website. Remember, this might not just be about you showcasing your school or your classroom. This might also be a way for young people to showcase their own work or e-portfolio, or indeed present an assignment. Moonfruit.com is another example of a free or freemium based website creation tool. All of these tools have different strengths and different weaknesses, and it's really up to you to go away and to decide what you think those strengths and weaknesses are. Google Sites, built into the Google Apps for Education suite, is also another chance where you might be able to develop a website. I flagged this up here because it was built by Callum Arthur, who's one of the participants on this course, and he didn't know much about website design before, but he's kind of figured this out himself in terms of drag and drop. So again, a powerful tool that could be used. Wix is also a very, very similar service. Again, it's freemium. There are free features, and you can also pay a little bit more for advanced features as well. But lots and lots of schools, particularly primary schools, seem to use Wix, and it's quite popular across Western Europe as well as in the UK. There are of course other platforms as well. Blogger is one of the first blogging platforms on the web, now owned by Google. A great way for kind of keeping an online diary, or a great way just to kind of keep news drip feeding into your audience. This is Dave Rogers, a friend of mine, an assistant head teacher from the south coast of England, who's been keeping his blog now for almost 10 years. And it's a great source of inspiration to me, but also what a great example of reflective practice. If you wanted to do something a little bit more sophisticated, maybe you want to check out Google Web Designer. This is a download that you need to use. But this is all about creating HTML5 based designs and apps and graphics that can run on pretty much any device. Actually, if you're just thinking about designing a website, then maybe you perhaps just want to use Facebook. If you think about the purpose, if the purpose is getting news out there or news feeds out there, and you think about a platform that pretty much most people use across Europe, then creating a school Facebook page is actually not a bad idea in terms of a quick and cheap way to create a website. And you don't even have to be a member of Facebook to be able to access the content, as long as you mess around with the settings. We'll talk a little bit more about Facebook and other social media during the next module, the last module, which is about using social media in schools. So you might be thinking, well, that's all very well. Those were a number of great tools, but how do I get about started? Well, go back to Google, right? Think about some of those tools that I've suggested there. Maybe explore some of the ones that you've not used. Many of those tools have actually got very simple tutorials that are built into them, and just have a play. And there are so many website creation tools that are out there now. If you find yourself not able to do it, then there's nothing wrong with the tool. You've just picked the wrong one. Maybe that's just not yet operating on the level that you're operating on. So go out there, see if you can find the tools and see if you can create some content. One last little thing I just wanted to mention is that the biggest mistake people make is that they develop websites for schools, websites for classrooms, websites for school systems, which aren't mobile and tablet friendly. If you're going to be designing a website, it's really, really important that it looks okay on a desktop computer, a laptop, a tablet, and of course a smartphone. Because increasingly, particularly young people will be accessing these resources on tablets and smartphones. Now, before we hang up from this module, there are two other tools that I just wanted to mention. The first tool is a tool called Mailchimp. Now, Mailchimp is a way of not creating a website, but being able to create a web page and then quickly email it out to a mailing list. It's incredibly powerful to get out your key messages. We use it for our weekly staff professional newsletter and also to communicate with parents. The second one I wanted to mention is isu.com. Isu.com, again, is not really a website creator, but it allows you to upload documents onto the website and be able to publish them online in this kind of online magazine format. Again, not quite a website, but maybe something that could be used in conjunction with a website, and certainly a great way to increase audience for your own work and to share your good news messages. Hopefully that's been a little bit helpful. As I say, it's a chance now to get away and play with some of those tools, perhaps suggest some ones that other ones that you've used, or perhaps even, you know, why don't you share your classroom blog or your school website with other people on the course so that we could all learn from each other. See you in the next video.